Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creating Process. Today we are going to work on graphic design. To design this, we'll first create the structure using blend tool. Then we'll give two different grading color on both ends. After that, add highlights and do color correction. So let's begin with the tutorial. Open a new Illustrator document. And the first thing we're gonna do is to create a basic shape of our design. So select the ellipse tool and draw a circle. Give the stroke thickness to 0.25 points. Now, using the selection tool, we'll create few more duplicates of the circle. With the Alt pressed, click and drag to create the duplicate. Let's give oval shape to this circle. In this way, we'll create multiple number of duplicates with a variation in size. The shape you give here will decide the look of your design. So experiment with different shapes. Once you are done, select all the shapes and combine them using the Unite option in Pathfinder. Then, using the Shape Builder tool, remove all the extra pieces inside the shape. Now, remove the fill color and change the stroke color to something different. Next, with the Alt pressed, click and drag to create another duplicate of the shape and place it around here. Now, we'll add blends between the two shapes. So select both the shapes, then double click on the blend tool to open the blend option panel. Here, set the spacing to specify steps and increase the value to 315 and click OK. Now, first click on the edge of the first shape. You can see the star icon. Then click on the second shape when the plus sign shows. This will create a blend between the two shapes. Now the next thing we're gonna do is to modify the path. So double click on the shape to go inside the blend. Here, using the direct selection tool, select the path and with the help of anchor point tool, click and drag to change the direction of the path. Do the same for the other endpoint. Now using the direct selection tool, you can use the handles to get the required shape. Next, select the right path and change the stroke color to light yellow. Then select the other path and change the color to dark pink. Now on the layer panel, open the blend layers and drag down the selected path on the bottom. This will send the left end to the back. Now let's apply gradient color. So select the first path, choose stroke color and apply gradient color. On the gradient panel, change the left slider color to yellow and then the right slider color to orange. Then drag the left slider closer to the right slider and set the angle of rotation to -90°. After this, select the second path and choose gradient color. Now for this, change the left slider color to pink and the right slider color to red under CMYK attributes. Then keep the angle of rotation to -90°. Next, double click outside and select the design using the selection tool. Then double click on the blend option and set the specified steps to 600. Now we'll do some modification of the shape. So with direct selection tool, select the path and we'll add 2 points using add anchor point tool. Now we can use these points to modify the shape precisely. Use the handles to change the flow. Also, rotate the angle to give more twist in the design. Do the same for the other end. Next, we'll do more color adjustments in Photoshop. So, drag and drop it to Photoshop document, scale up the size and place it here. Now, add a new brightness and contrast adjustment layer. Set the contrast value to 21 points and the brightness value to -3. Then add a new layer and change the layer mode to color dodge. We'll use this layer to add highlights. So select the color using eye picker and apply it using soft brush tool. Draw it over the area where you want to give highlights. Use low opacity brush to blend the colors. Also choose yellow color to give yellow highlights over this region. Next, we'll add hue and saturation adjustment layer. Set the saturation value to +73 and the hue value around +4. You can also use curve adjustment layer to play around with different tones of color and highlights. But for this, we are not going to use curve adjustment layer. Next, let's modify the shape. So first, right click and convert the layer to smart object. Now using warp option, let's increase the thickness. Click and drag to do the adjustments. Once done, press enter. Next, type out a title text, fluid, change the text color to white, and choose a proper font. For this, we're going to use 11" empty regular font and place it in the middle. Finally, we have completed designing fluid graphic design. During the process, we have used blend tools to give a nice blending shape. Then we have applied gradient color on both ends with a little twist. Lastly, we have done color adjustment in Photoshop. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.